या मामा नी या मामा याडी कामा काना का काना कामा काडी या मामा या नी मामा या का याडी काया का ताया रारा ताया या तारा राया ता काया काडी या काया. No, this is not Greek or Latin or any other language. This is, of course, Tamil. These verses, these two verses, are from a work called Devaram, written by the great poet Thirunyana Sambandaram. What is special is that it is that what is called palindrome. That is, you can read it from the beginning to the end, and also from the end to the beginning. It will be the mirror image, it will be the same. And the meaning, it's not without any meaning, it's pure Tamil. I'll also tell you the meaning. It says that, well, you're the only truth, oh, one who has that great heart, and one who is adored by everyone, one who is having snake, and he, the one who made the Manmada vanish, oh Lord of Sirgadi, oh creator of illusions, deliver, release me from the dark Maya. Now, why did I start? Of course, I normally start my sessions with a verse from Tamil literature. This time I thought of starting with this because apart from that mirror image, it's musical. I'm sure all of you will agree, it's musical to listen to. There is music not only in swaras, there is music in poetry. There is poetry not only in words, there is poetry in music as well. That is why I thought of starting this session with that, because we are going to focus this time, we are going to focus more on classical elements. Generally, it is the person who says, Raga is just a tool, why do you break your head? And now the same person is saying ragas and when the equivalence of ragas and rags, why? Is there a contradiction? Well, it's nice to contradict. As I write in some of the Bona, anything? You raise your hand, is that by mistake? Anyway, whatever it is.
Yeah, by mistake.
Oh, I'm sorry. Going to see the charts now. Well, Raga is just a tool, fine. At the same time, our country has given so much to the world in terms of music, in terms of literature, yes, in terms of spirituality as well. But music, as I said in my promo video, Indian classical music is unique for its Raga structure. And we have two branches, Carnatic and Hindustan. Before I go on with that, what I'm going to do is, I'm taking down the memory lane. Actually, only today I was reminiscing about my childhood with one of my friends who is here. Now, this happened long, long ago when I was a small child. If you remember the song I mentioned, the lines I mentioned in the promo video, Isai Ketal Puri Asaindadum. That is from a movie called Tavakkudalvan, where Sivaji Ganesan, I think, plays the role of Tansen, Mia Tansen, in the play. And well, it is believed that Mia Tansen sang a raga called Deepak, and the entire town or the entire palace was lighted. Now, here in this play, what though I have not watched the movie, I know that story. Now, in this play, Sivaji Ganesan sings that song. Not in Deepak, it's purely based on Kalyani. Anyway. And the heroine, that is Kaya Vijaya, is lying down. And what happens is, she gets up at the end. But most importantly, the lights start glowing. So what I used to do during those days, listening to the radio, nobody was around. It was around evening, somewhere around 6 o'clock. So I switched off all the lights in the bedroom and I was always glued to the radio set. And when the song was being played, I switched off all the lights and As the climax was reaching the second charanam, I switched on the lights. Well, I didn't know anything about raga. I didn't know anything about Deepak or Kalyani or anything. Just a kind of one. I'll tell you why I'm narrating this. Now, flash forward to my days in Hyderabad, where we used to actually those days, Tamil movies were shown as morning shows. So we would and it would come after 6 months or so. Only morning shows on Sundays. 3 days. Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays. So we will go on a Sunday. And there was a theater called Prashant. There is a person here by that name. Now Prashant, what they would do is they would play Shehanai instrument. And actually, as per the South Indian tradition, on Sundays, you were supposed to have an oil bath. That itself makes one drowsy. So I'll be sleeping. And my father, closing his eyes, would be enjoying that Shehanai piece. Yeah, Prashant, I'll come to that. I'm not seeing what it is. He would be enjoying, and I would actually bang my head. I would say, how can he even tolerate this music? It is so dull. How can he even stand this music? Yes, that was instant music. And that it was yours truly there. Now, how the transformation happened, well, most of you know how I got into music from nobody, of course, even now I'm not great, just to a certain extent, I know something. And due to one gentleman. Now, apart from that, once I got into that, there used to be a program called Sangeet Sarita at 7:30 a.m. on Vivid Bharati, where they would talk about one raga and play one classical song, pure classical, and then play film song, Hindi film song, of course. And that is when slowly I got into that. There were so many terms like Wadi Samadhi and when it should be sung. Say first Pahla Pahar, Dusra Pahar, then Subha, so many things, morning, early morning, so many. I was just wondering what is all this about, but slowly I got into that. So that is Hindustani music, my brush with Hindustani music. And from a person who was absolutely against that sound coming, I became a connoisseur of Hindustani music, and to a certain extent, with this I've shared with some of my friends, also with my family, to a certain extent, I even prefer Hindustani to Tamil because of the meditative effect. Okay, that is one part. Now, let us get into the. I'll not bore you with too much history or my childhood. My childhood history is over now. But again, what is this Hindustani? What is this Carnatic? Most of you know, but at the same time, I thought I must tell you just a brief idea about what it is, and then I'll move on. And in the structure, I've already told in the promo video. So, as I mentioned, I think even in my previous presentation, and also in the presentation on music in Tamil literature, music started from here, from the Tamil land. It's an indisputable fact because there are references, there is evidence for that. So there was nothing called Carnatic music. You had Silapadigaram, which has a lot of mention about music. Then even the grammar text Tulkapiyam, and then you have that there were some books written on dance, Kuthanu, and so many other things. And yes, in Sanskrit there was something called Natya Shastra, written around the same time. That has reference to music, but it doesn't say anything about Carnatic of Hindustan until the 12th century. In the 12th century, somebody by name Saranga Deva wrote Sangeeta Ratnakara. And there is also mention about Devar, but still no mention about Carnatic or Hindustan. And this went on for some time until 16th century, when a saint by name Purandara Dasa was born in, of course, Karnataka. Well, that is not the reason for that Carnatic music. There is a lot of confusion about why that name. I'll come to that. And he is called as Pitamaha of Carnatic music because he systematized and even now that Gitam and other things which are being taught to young kids, people who are learning music, were composed by Purandara Dasa. And then after 17th century, then 18th century, there was somebody called Venkata Makhin who systematized everything, the Melakarta system. There are 72 Melakartas. Melakartas are just parent ragas, just take it like that, parent ragas, which are complete, which has, which have all the seven swaras. And it is systematized. Then were born the Srinidhi, Tyagaraja, Dikshitar, and Damasatri, and a lot of composers. That is what is Carnatic music. It, as I said, ragas, in the name, by the name we know, did not exist before that, before 16th century at least. It was all the Tamil music, fun. Now, going to Hindustani music. Hindustani music also followed, probably it just branched out. It just branched out after 15th century, and Mughal influence cannot be denied. So Hindustani music also had a raga system. And but it was not organized, it was not systematized until 19th, early part of 20th century, when somebody by name Marathi gentleman by name Vishnu Narayan Bhatkar. No, he was the one who systematized Hindustani music with a thought. So, simple understanding. So, ragas almost remain the same, though Carnatic music has some special ragas, Hindustani music as well. But the difference is the way it is sung and the way some phrases are used. For example, you have equivalent, most of the ragas are equivalent, most don't have the equivalent. For example, Mohanam as an equivalent, Hindunam as an equivalent, such simple ragas are equivalents, but not many have. Though raga system is there. And there has been the mutual transfer. See, Hamsadhwani was adopted into Hindustani music. Then there are so many, Kiravani was adopted into Hindustani music, and Chadukesi for that matter. Right from there, Carnatic music adopted Mand, Deha, Hamid Kalyani, and so on. So this is just a basic understanding. Just a basic understanding so that people who do not know or who just want, people who are wondering what is Hindustani music all about or Carnatic music all about, this is what it is. Carnatic music, why the name? Some say because Purandara Dasa was born in Karnataka, not really. Karna means ears in Sanskrit. So one which is pleasing to the ears, that is Carnatic music, that's one school of thought. Then the entire region south of Tungabhadra was called Karnataka region. So since it came from there, some people say. But anyway, let us not break our heads on that. So let us move on. Now the structure will be, I will be starting with a Hindustani rag and an equivalent in Carnatic music. Play a song, maybe say very few words. I'm not going to bore you with theory. You are already bored. I'm not going to bore you more with theory. Let us get on with music now. And let us get started with a beautiful song. First, it will be Hindustani rag and a song based on that rag. And then I will talk about that and I'll move on to a Carnatic equivalent. Right. Let us listen to this marvel from sung by a great legend, not a Hindustani legend. Anyway, though it's based on Hindustani rag, it's sung by a Carnatic legend. Let us listen to that.
இன்ன அன்னபூரணி இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி நின்னடி தொழ தொழ இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி அகம்பூருகே அன்பர் பாடிட பாடிட இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி அகம்பூருகே அன்பர் பாடிட பாடிட இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி அந்தரி சிவசங்கரியனும் ஆதிமூலமே செந்தமிழ் மணி மந்திரம் உன்னை வாழ்த்தும் நாளுமே மோகமும் அறமுன்னை அற எண்ணியவரம் கைகளில் வர பாடல் புனைந்து பூஜை புரிந்து கண்ணீர் கசிந்து நின்னடி தொழ தொழ பாடல் புனைந்து பூஜை புரிந்து கண்ணீர் கசிந்து நின்னடி தொழ தொழ இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி அகம்பூருகி அன்பர் பாடிட பாடிட இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி தினம் நர்த்தனம் இடும் ஈசன் பாதியே இல்லையில் தினம் நர்த்தனம் இடும் ஈசன் பாதியே சென்னிற ஒளி நின்னிட எழும் தீபஜோதியே மலை மன்னவன் மகள் பைரவிருமை விழிபட தீமை ஓடுங்கும் தர்மம் புலங்கும் வாய்மை விளங்கும் நின்னடி தொழ தொழ தீமை ஓடுங்கும் தர்மம் புலங்கும் வாய்மை விளங்கும் நின்னடி தொழ தொழ இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி அகம்பூருகி அன்பர் பாடிட பாடிட இன்னருள் தரும் அன்னபூரணி
ஓம் சக்தி 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 ஓம் சக்தி
Some of you rightly said it is of course from Mahatma and sung by the great Carnatic legend Sri V.N. Seshagopalan sir. And, well, many people actually I saw the comment Swaminathan. Many people consider this as Gaud Malhar, but it is not. It is Durga. Gaud Malhar in the Avarohanam has all the seven swaras. This doesn't have. This is pure Durga. no doubt about that. I've seen such comments in, on social media as well, but I'm thoroughly convinced that this is not God Mantra. Maybe the start, the Pallavi, the, just the beginning, reminds one of Sarasamu. That is why people think, I think they're not going beyond that. And actually, I forgot to mention one thing. I'm also going to mention about some of the compositions of the great legends in the Raga. Not just Raja sir, this time for a change. And also some of the compositions of this legend in the same Raga. One of the other compositions, beautiful compositions, its song is Raga. So there are, and also that song from Devar Mahal. It is wrongly given as Sudha Sagari. Now, what is the difference? Well, the Carnatic equivalent is Sudha Sagari, but it is the pakat. What is pakat? Pakat is literally meaning catch. But at the same time, it is the phrases. For example, in Carnatic music as well, we have similar. For example, Ananda Bariman and Riti Gowda have almost the similar for us, but the way it is sung. In Hindustani music, there are many rags which have the same set of notes, but are different. I mean, those rags are different because of the way it is sung. Okay, now Viraj will just sing a piece of Durga, and then we move on to the Carnatic equivalent, which is Sudha Sagari. This rimmer is a phrase is repeated. There are also some other phrases. So I, as I said, since I'm not going technical, this is Durga and so is Radha Radha Niyange and that Devar Mahan that Manamahale Manamahale. Okay. Now, Sudha Sagari is the Carnatic equivalent. And what I must say is that Sudha, there are some ragas, I think I mentioned in one of my, many of my previous sessions, also in my post, that there are ragas which can be used in live music and they sound like. For example, Chakravartin is a classical raga. At the same time, it can be used in a lighter manner, Keeravani for that matter. But there are ragas which even if they are used in the live music form, will retain that classicism. And Sudha Sagari is one such raga. Kovil Mani Osai Thanne is one of the examples, but I have already played it in one of my sessions, so that I'm not going to play that. If you want to guess what it is, keep guessing. This is another favorite of mine. So let us listen to that. And there is, of course, Listen to the beautiful Shehnai in the second interview. By, he was known for that. He was known for his brigas, and probably Raja sir must have thought that, well, it's a Hindustani rag, let me make a person known for brigas to sing whatever it is. I don't know how many really know that, yes, this great legend is sung for Raja sir. Okay, now moving on to the song which I was talking about. It's a vintage composition. Let us listen to that. And there is a hidden magic in that which you see after we finish listening to the entire song. I saw the comment just now. Is it still? Do you still have the echo? Do you still have the echo? Or is it fine now? Can somebody wait? Let me just see. Do you still hear the echo? Some places, but are weak. No, let me play this song. Can you just let me know once? Just put it in the chat box. Probably I've removed the mic. Is it the mic problem? I really don't know. I don't want to experiment. Is it clear now? I'll also put on the mic later, but if it's clear, just type out why. Okay, thank you. Let me just put on the mic and then. Now do you hear any echo? Now do you hear any echo? Is it okay, my voice? Okay, thank you. In case there is any problem, just let me know, because don't miss certain things, because I'm going to talk about some of the hidden magic as well. Well, this is Sudha Saveri. I just saw a comment that it's Pahari. Now, why? It's because I've also seen, just like the Gaudmala confusion is something different, but yeah, If Shuddha Saveri is played somewhat technical in the Madhyama Shruti, it becomes Pahadi. That is the magic of music. So one can hear, one can even for that matter, Devade Idam Devade from Pattapati Bhairavan, some people call it Shuddha Saveri. It is not. It is Pahadi. The confusion of that Shruti, so one has to be very careful here. Actually, the Pahadi touch is felt, it was actually part of my presentation as well. I wanted to say that here you feel Pahadi. Now listen to the prelude. You just, it is of course Kalyan Raman, sorry, I forgot to tell you this, from Kalyan Raman 1979 movie, sung by S.P. Shailaja, Sri Devi lip syncing for that. And now it is just a young girl singing going wrong, and the music starts with the, it seems as if the flowers are blooming. Just listen to the first bit. That is wonderful. And here one can, the next string section, if you don't listen properly, you can call it Pahadi. If you take the ma as base, it is Pahadi. So it's all, see, music is subjective finally, right? I'm reminded of something, that is when somebody, I think I mentioned in one of the sessions as well, when somebody went to sing to him, it seems he said, okay, sing. And the girl said, no, sir, I need Shruti. So he just looked at her like a worm. He said, what Shruti? What you hear is Shruti. Shruti should be here. So Shruti is here. So how that matters, now, Subhashini, don't comment that Shruti is Kamala as his daughter. I know you're capable of saying that. Now, I was talking about the hidden magic. So I'm just jumping to Madhimati field. Well, that's because of something else. But again, there is, he does something here in the second interlude, which I think Geetanjali, people who attended Geetanjali long ago will remember. Well, second interlude, listen to that. He has kept the Rishabham as the base and shifted to Sudha Danyasi. This is Griha Vedam as per Carnatic music parlance. As Hindustani music in Hindustani music parlance, it is called Murchana. So keeping Ri as the base, move to Sudha Danyasi. Actually, Jay Ganesh, one can go from Sudha Saveri to Madhimavati as well, all the five pentatonic themes. I covered that in one of my Raj Gita sessions, and there is a post also. Okay, let us listen to this marvel now. That is keeping the knee of Sudha Danyasi as the base, moved back to Sudha Saveri. Griha Vedam, I have already spoken many times, probably many of my course also have that. So that is the magic they were talking about. Now listen to the first interlude. Now, it is like, I think the birds are singing in Sudha Saveri. Just listen to that. Even the woodpecker is sounding in Sudha Saveri towards the end. Just listen to this. No, 1 minute. Sorry, that's a wrong. Bird call in Sudha Saveri, and then see what follows. Well, even birds, of course, nothing can match the music from nature and music of nature. Okay, that's what he's trying to convey here. Okay, now we saw two rags. That is, one was Durga equivalent, Karnataka equivalent, this is the Saveri. Now,